Hello guys and welcome to the Beyond Sanas channel. My name is Shanks and today we're gonna take a look into the Engmar faction in the Edain mod for BFME 2 The Rise of the Witch King against the Heart Army, this time on the map Nave of Lorien. Let's get it started. And wish me luck because I believe, you know, I'm struggling still in this mod because I need to read so many stuff and I'm completely not used to this mod just yet, and playing the faction one time isn't gonna change that. You need to play that multiple times to get into the game. And we are playing the Engmar faction. That's how the Engmar castle is looking like. Pretty nice, if you ask me. Let's build the mills to get some money. And these are the Thralmaster units. We can turn them into the Gundabad warriors. Let's do this. Just like in Rise of the Witch King, you know? And we need to split them to get those settlements as soon as possible. So that's like an Elven map. Oh, there is a lair. We can't fight this right now. Let's avoid fighting this and let's get to this mill or settlement. Oh, that's also protected. Oh my goodness. PowerPoint wise, we have the Dark Obelisk. Obelisk, the Tormentor. Summons a Dark Obelisk which will weaken the enemy, nearby enemy units and reveal hidden units. And then we have also the Blight. Spreads a terrible plague at the target enemy resource buildings, causing it to produce less resources and increase the production time of upgrades. Okay, I mean, we have like zero settlements outside for now. And creeping is kind of questionable or kind of tough, you know? As for the heroes, we are able to recruit Drauglin, who is a very cheap hero, and then the Witch King of Engmar for 4,000, who is a very expensive hero on the other side. Here we are able to build four different things. Barrow, Orc Camp, or Wolf Lair. Let's build a village. We need more money. And now we need to creep. And what I would recommend you to do is closing the gate. Close the gate the second you can and we're against Guardians. So let's pick up this one, I guess. We have no other choice. He was using Rallying Call already. We gotta fight this, guys. Let's use this one. That's gonna make them, I believe, weaker, yeah? That's gonna make them weaker. It's gonna be like a debuff. Our hero is the tank. Okay. Okay, this hero is not very strong. Let me tell you that much. He's actually extremely weak. Let's peel back. Let's use hold ground stance when we fight. Don't get killed, please. Can we trample? You can't even trample them down, really. Wolf cannot expansion. Let's do this. Hopefully it's gonna be helping us out a little bit so we can get some more defense around the gate. Looks like we're gonna be able to win this, even though he was using Rallying Call, but I believe the Obelisk, the Tormentor, is able to make the enemy units weak enough for us to take them down. And after being able to deal with that, we can just try to creep this Goblin Lair, I believe. And our hero is gonna heal up over time a little bit, so it's gonna be fine. We are in a good spot. Let's build one more mill and then we will need to start recruiting some units. Okay, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Not time wasting. There are multiple settlements, but I believe most of them are kind of protected. So let's please handle the situation. I don't know if we can kill them. Level 3 unlocked. What is this? What is this? The Beastmaster can feel the weakness of his enemies and can track their trail. For 30 seconds, a chosen enemy unit or building gets revealed and gives the Beastmaster and his wolves 50% damage and 20% armor if they are nearby. Okay, we don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that. Okay, you go. You go maybe. Oh, there is another lair. There is another lair. Everything is kind of protected. So now we need to start getting some units on the field. Werewolves, Hall of the Kingsmen. Let's get Hall of the Kingsmen for some more Thralmaster units, I believe. The good thing about the Thralmaster units is you can turn them into anything you want, like Gundabad Warriors or, for example, the Wolf Packs. Literally everything what you need. And by the way, guys, I mentioned this a couple of times, but just in case you missed, we have also now our second YouTube channel, which is being mainly used for the uploads of Twitch. So the live streams you are not able to watch because you are busy. You can now watch them on our second YouTube channel. And also the link for that is in the description down below. So let's get Thralmaster units. Build one more mill. And then I would also like to take a look into the wolf or the kennels. For some mobile units like wolf riders. We were able to defend ourselves for now. Let's get to this layer right after. The Vork layer is a bit more challenging. That's why we're gonna creep the Goblin layer first. Someone is attacking us still. I don't know what is attacking us. Oh, Goblin. So let's kill them first. Oh, there they come. Guardians. But they are getting debuffed all the time. We have also Wolves now for the defense. Build cages. Enemy units lose damage and armor. Nearby units. So let's open the gate. Even though it's not the best thing in the world, let me tell you that much. This one was able to deal with this situation, not a big deal. We can also turn him into the skin changer. Let's get it into the wolf mod. Level 5 is unlocked, that's good. We will be able to defend ourselves for now. We can get some more units on the field. We can also recruit heroes. Like for example, Waldo. Okay, let's get more units on the field. Spam units all the time, you know? What is this? Tribute card. What am I supposed to do with this? Into a recruitment building of Engma to upgrade it, generate resources. Alright, I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. But we will... Oh, he killed all our units? Nope, he didn't. Oh, be careful! We are getting attacked from this. Oh, he has fallen. He has fallen into darkness. It's bad. We have wolves now on the field. Turn them into the Gundabad warriors for now, I guess. That's all we can really do. This is gonna be a whole ability, right? Okay, go. Mill. We need more money. Yes, battle wagons already. So we need pikemen. We need to spam units all the time, guys. That's what it is. This is not looking much different than a mill, though. I don't like this design of this building. It's looking pretty much like the mill, but you have like a gate around this area. So pretty similar from the design. We need to defend this area. I would be in love with one more outside settlement, because we have not that much money, as you can see and tell. We have 2 power points collected. We can use that for the frozen land. Freezes an enemy on terrain. Enemy units will lose 50% of their movement speed and lose all leadership bonuses. And it's gonna be also used to cover the Elven Wood or Tainted Land. With 5, the Might of the Iron Crown lowers the cooldown of all hero abilities by 20%. So it's not the best thing in the world. And summon hill trolls. Let's get the Blight. Let's try to kill this dude. And now... We are not able to recruit any of these just yet. But we can turn them into the Wolf Riders. Let's spam more of these. It's only level 1. Let's get more of these too. We will be able to eventually take him down at some point. He's so tanky. The Battle Wagon level 3. Look how long it takes for us to take him down actually. That's crazy. More units are coming at the same time. We can trample them down now. This is no problemo. He has no pikemen around. Also, we need faster units. We need more and faster units. That's what we need. As for the Ring Heroes, only Ring Heroes can pick up the One Ring. Once the Witch King receives the One Ring, several effects will become active immediately. All enemy resource production and units training will be slowed by 25%, and all enemies will have reduced movement speed while the Witch King has the ring. Okay? So nothing crazy actually about this one. We captured this one. That's great. Let's build one more of these. And let's creep the Goblin layer next to our base to get yet one more settlement. Very important. Get more units. Let's get mobility units, you know? Are they good against pikemen? I don't know. We will find out. Also, you turn into this. We are command points capped, so we need to get more units on the field. Upgrade this storerooms to get more command points. That's what I'm trying to say. This layer is gonna be creeped. This time we have a lot of units on the field, unlike the games before. Which is good, because this way we can also get the power points a bit faster from the spellbook. And have more map control, you know? I was playing too passive all games until this one. Because I wanted always to see what is possible, what can I do, and read through everything, which was a major mistake. Get ready to build. Can I send him in this one? Question mark? What happens if I send him in? Nothing happens, actually. Interesting. So let's demolish one of the mills. Keep this and get this one as well. And we need to build something. I believe it's gonna be the Iron Forge. To upgrade our resource buildings to level 2 and eventually to level 3, you know, inside and outside of the base. Let's get this one right after. This one has no protection, no creeps around, that's good. And now we can also creep the work layer. Let's get the settlements first, you know, before anything else. To boost the money a little bit, which is always nice. Get this and then just recruit more units at the same time. Yeah. 900, oh my goodness, the workers tools for 900, that's a lot of money. We need to defend this. The Wolf Riders, you guys need to peel back. You will die against the pikeman. He's going inside, boys. Why can I not? Requires level 2. How can I get this level 2? Get X-Rovers. No, no, oh, not pikemen. X-Rovers I wanted, but it's okay. It's okay. Can you creep this one, guys? Apparently not. This works are so strong. What is this? Please defend. Don't lose this mill, I'm telling you. Research banner carry upgrade. Let's get hill trolls. Siege trolls, they are called. What happens if I send them in? Nothing. Nothing happens besides losing the unit. That's what happens. Tribute card. Can I get it to level 2 this way? That's the big question. Please? Yeah, okay, that's nice. That's nice. Okay, now we can get this. Did we creep this? Yes, we did. Nice. Good job. Get more Trailmaster units in the meantime. We need also X-Trovers, guys. That's what it is. X-Trovers. There we go. Okay, we have a lot of settlements outside, which is good. To get more money. Because this way we can get also this to level 2. On settlements to rank 2, which means 25% more money, which is great because look how many we have, you know? Let's defend this area and let's push from this side at the same time. There is a settlement we can capture, there is a troll layer. Let's get this settlement too. Because that's what we do. And let's keep moving on. Defend. Attack, defend, attack, defend, attack. Eventually, we will win this game. And hopefully, unlike last time with the Dwarven faction, this time, hopefully, we will be able to find... What is this? Siege Ram. We're done with that one. I don't know. The enemies who shall I bring to our banner? They will submit. You'll do it, you told. Our mills. The battle wagon has been finally taken down. Hey, 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 be careful with the Wolf Riders. Trample. One more trample. Deals decent amount of damage though, the trample. Almost one shots this Guardians. I mean, two shots. They're gonna take so much damage from the trample. Watch this. But you need to be fast, you know, before moving, before trampling again. Like, for example, now, it's gonna trample them down. It's very important. He's just getting inside the base and trying to destroy our buildings, which, what a memer. Erebor, take him down, take him down, take him down. Let's get it to level 3. It's only level 1 still, we will need more units on the field, and also increase the store. Get it to level 3 once it's available. For Angmar. Can I also put him inside the mill? No, that's not possible. Okay, let's move on. Let's trample them down and we can also try to peel back. This is gonna be unfortunately taken down, but it's fine. Now, siege. You guys peel back. In safety. We will need more X-Trovers. This is only level 2 yet. So let's get it to level 3 in this case. Let's keep fighting here. Well, he has used Rallying Call. But you know what? I can also use my own debuff to make them a bit weaker. He has Gandalf. Already. Okay, we have 5 power points collected. We can go for the Fellwind. This is kind of tricky. I don't know about that, man. 20% cooldown reduction for the heroes, but we have zero heroes for now. Oof. Let's choose these two first, you know? Let's go like that. Did we take it down? Yeah, we took it down. So we need more units. And now we have level 2, which gives us the chance to recruit stronger units, apparently. Okay, we need more and more units on the field. And now we can get this one to level 3 for more money inside the base. And then right after this one to level 3 for more money outside of the base. And also, once again, the buildings are gonna be tankier. Very important too. We need to wait. We have lost the entire army right there. Get more wolf packs on the field. He's coming. No back talk, worms. But, you know, we are doing not bad so far. We need to just get more and more units on the field all the time. Let's give them Banner maybe. Yeah, Banner. They have also charge attack, Duelisk. Gain 50% damage against Elite and 100% damage against Heroic units for 30 seconds. Pretty nice. This has been taken down. Let's trample them down maybe. Wolfpacks are coming too. Maybe some more Bowmen for extra defense would be nice. We have lost. This farm is going to be eventually taken down as well. You guys need to take down this catapult ASAP. It's level 3 already, so we can maybe put him inside this one. That's going to give us the chance, once it's level 3, to recruit the werewolf. Defend, defend, defend. Let's get him banner too. We took it down, it's good. Let's use aggressive stance. Look how long it takes to kill those. Oh my goodness, he took it down, guys. He took it down, he took it down. We need archers. Archers. We need also potentially ice arrows. And heavy armor, everything. We need everything. We need to reclaim this, that's for sure. The Wolf Riders are not bad, actually. They are better than BFME too. Let's get this. Ice Arrows is gonna be the next upgrade. And then, once we have the money, also the heavy mail, the heavy armor, the forge blades for the other units. Oh my goodness, this battle wagon is crushing us. Please kill him. We need more pikemen for the protection. He's using Rallying Call now on his army. We need to peel back. Let's trample them down. We have no Wolf Riders left anymore. That's the problemo. Punish. They're attacking our mill once again. Oh my goodness, man. Let's use frozen land to make them slower. With the pikemen, maybe we can kill them a bit faster. What is this unit going inside the jeans? Level 5. And the build speed is so slow too. Oh my goodness, man. Get Waldo. Oh my goodness. Guys, 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 we need to peel back. This guy's gonna take down our fortress with this zealots or whatever these units are. Put them on top of the wall maybe, I don't know. More units are needed. He's going hardcore inside the jeans. All this arrived, it's good. Keep fighting. Oh, this level 3 mid is going down, am I right? Yeah, it's going down. This needs ages to build, dude. Oh, man. Please. Oh, we lost the level 3. I mean, it doesn't matter because once we build it, it's gonna be level 3 again, but still, you know? Kinda annoying if you lose stuff like that. Please, I shot already, man. Can we also build something like a enemy? Okay, let's build this one for lower damage and defense, maybe. Okay, I shot finally available. That's gonna hopefully make us a bit stronger. Level 3 doesn't really do much. Oh, it does. Okay, we need to put them inside then. Also, let's get these upgrades unlocked. because we can afford it. We can always go for the Witch King later on, you know? Ideally, when we have enough... Oh my goodness. Ideally, when we have enough money for... when we have the One Ring found, you know? When we know where the Golem is, then we can always get Witch King. We have 5 power points collected. Turncats of Arnor. Summon 3 battalions of Turncats from Arnor to the battlefield. Okay, let's get this. Special summon is always great. Let's summon him immediately and then use Fell Wind on the battle wagon, which is unaffected apparently. Now we have reinforcements. Voldo. Pillage, right? No. Okay, so no pillage. No money boosts, unfortunately. We have almost lost everything around this area too. So let's recruit these units.
We don't have enough resources for that.
We have no resources for that. Yeah, you guessed it right. You guys keep moving on. Let's kill this battle wagon, please. There is another mineshaft. We lost almost every single resource building. That's really bad. This is from us. Yeah, that's good. Now we have some sort of defense. Hopefully it's gonna be good defense and we don't need to close the gate. Let's give them also heavy armor to make them a bit tankier, I guess. Also, the upgrades are very expensive, man. They cost 300 each, you know. Not cheap at all. Let's give them banner plus this. Let's join the main army and reclaim the map control if we can. Just keep fighting all the time. We need also pikemen. Because he is getting many, many battle wagons on the field. And battle wagons are going to trample us down all the time if we don't have any pikemen around. And these units can't receive any leadership, by the way. Okay, we need to put them inside this one. This has to be level 2 already, you know? So, yeah, armor instead of blades, and we will go for the blades anyway, right? So, blades is getting almost purchased. And hopefully, this way we can kill these buildings a little bit faster, because right now, we lack of damage big time. Are they permanent? Yeah, they were permanent, I didn't know that. I wouldn't lose them like that if I would know that, you know? They are coming from the bottom side. We need to kill them. Let's give them all blades to make them stronger. Now they have full upgrades. And I have high expectations because of the reason. Now we have a huge army. With the ice shots, we should be able to defend ourselves. Just like the Dark Rangers from the Ingmar faction. Yeah, I think we can just keep going now. Let's keep moving from the bottom side. And just also look for the One Ring. We have 2 ranges on top of the wall. So with that being said, with the Wolf Cannon expansion in front of the gate, we should be in a good spot. But we can just recruit maybe some more of these Rangers. Or the elite, you know, units from the Ingmar faction. And as for the expansions on top of the wall, we are able to build trebuchets, the tower upgrade, and the postern gate with the build cages. Hopefully we're gonna be able to creep this dude. Level 3, Battle Rage. With every attack, Waldo grants nearby vassals 40% damage for 10 seconds. So pretty nice. Now we have a huge army. We can also recruit now these Shadow Guards. Let's put them on top of the gate for extra defense. The creep is going to be secured, that's good. And now we are able to build the outpost from Ingmar also at the bottom right side. Get the money from the creep. Amazing, beautiful. And let's keep moving on. Let's fight this, no problem. We have a huge army now. White Slayer, we don't have this one yet. Build the tower for the defense. And keep moving on. Now, look, this is a perfect situation, you know, you see that? Like a, you know, like the Troy defense from the film, you know what I'm saying? You know the Troy movie? They can't get inside anymore. I want to see the damage against buildings. It's a little bit better, but not too much. It's not like really great yet, you know? Here we are able to recruit the Barrow Whites. Infantry healing. Let's take a look into that. We are also able to recruit Karsh. From this one. They are coming. They were able to destroy one of the buildings in front. But you see our defense is hitting like a truck, dude. Very great defense. It's level 2 already. We need to get it to level 3, man. We need to get it to level 3, guys. And that's only possible. You get like a couple of cards every couple of minutes, I believe. Just build this one is also. double is better. Let's keep moving on. He has some catapults, that's why. Bloodlust. For 30 seconds, the Trolls in Waldo's direct vicinity gain twice as much damage from his battle reach. Hold on a second, let's get this one first. Every upgrade is purchased, by the way, from this, which is amazing. And then we can... I want to get these units first on the field to see what they are able to do. This build speed is also amazing, I like that. Now we have great defense, you know? He can only make something happen with, like, siege weapons. That's the only possible way, you know? Let's build this and keep moving on. Let's keep pressuring him all the time from this area. That's the Barrow White. Okay. I mean, we need more money. That's for sure. Level 6, that's great. Level 7, summon Bone Breakers. Waldo permanently summons a horde of Bone Breakers, which gain additional benefits from his Raider's Frenzy and Battle Rage. And then with level 10, Scorched Earth. Waldo tearing an enemy building down. Nice. Not bad. Let's kill this. These are the special units. Okay, we are not able to give them any experience or something like that. Level 3 is incoming and we can also recruit the werewolves. Just, you know, those are the elite units, I believe. But you are not... you can get them as many times as you want, you know? They are quite expensive though. Level 3, there you go. Oh, Wolf Tamer's Pits level 3. Wolf Breeding and Heavy Spike Colors upgrade has been... Okay, we need this one. This is level 3. And Wolf Breeding and Heavy Spike Colors. What is Wolf Breeding? This one, okay. We just need this one, actually. Okay. So let's can't even talk. Let's recruit one more of these. Get this mill. And keep moving on. Let's fight. Our units are hey. Why are you ignoring us? That's so annoying, you know, when he's just ignoring us and trying to go for the resource building instead. Come on, dude. Don't do that to me. Okay. With every attack, the Black Guards passively reduce the damage of nearby units by 50% for 10 seconds. Activate the ability to remove this effect for 30 seconds and reduce the Black Guards' armor by 50, but drain health from enemies with every strike and heal all nearby allies. Okay. Now we are able to recruit two of these. Oh, he has Gandalf here. Okay. This guy's abusing Gandalf all the time. That's pretty tilting. Chase him. Don't let him escape. Oh my goodness, this Gandalf is actually pogging, guys. He's pogging really hard. He's crushing us. Level 7. Let's summon more reinforcements. Gandalf, come on, man. Come on, man. Nice. Level 8? Great. Are we also able to get upgrades? Nope, that's not being the possible case. Okay, we shouldn't have chased him down, I guess. But it's fine. Better safe than sorry. So everything is level 3 already, you know? Maybe we can put these into this one. Doesn't really matter when we get to level 3 because we have no other units we are able to recruit. And now we have a lot of money. That's good. And now we can also start recruiting some heroes. I bleed. Devour. That's the big werewolf. Devour. Oh, wait a second. Hold on a second. Please, my friend. Get away. I was not paying attention. We lost all our army to Gandalf, though. That's pretty unfortunate. Waldo has to run for his life. Let's build a mill to save some time. And we have to sacrifice some of those units. But it's fine. They have also different colors, as you can see. Now I would love to get some heroes on the field. Let's get both of these heroes, if we can. They are getting recruited pretty fast now from a level 3 building. Then let's get Karsh. From this building, we are not able to recruit any heroes. Now we can resummon them. Let's resummon them. Level 5 unlocked. Can we upgrade them too? Nope, we are not able to upgrade them, right? No, it's not possible, unfortunately. And join them. I mean, that's all we can really do. It's level 3 already. Oh, what is that?
I command the Dark Dunedain.
Okay, we are getting our additional heroes. Great, great, great. Let's get Karsh. Volo can join the army too. Now we have a really strong, really, really strong army, guys. And also you can join the army. So we have now two heroes. More Nemarv. Unit support. He has a 460 melee damage. 4500 health. Same with Durmav. So with that being said, they are way stronger than Voldo. Way, way stronger than Voldo. And the only hero we are missing out is actually... I mean, Karsh is gonna be there soon. Then it's gonna be only Witch King, you know? Witch King is gonna be the only hero we are missing out. So for that reason, let's group all together here. Alright, so get some defense. Karsh has arrived. That's great. Karsh has Chill Soul. Drains 20% of all damage taken he deals as life force. His attacks reduce the damage of enemies in the vicinity by 30% for 20 seconds. Oh, but he's also a glass cannon. That's what you need to tell me too. Can you get inside, my dude? Please get inside the genes. Please get inside the genes, I'm telling you. Dude! Oh my goodness. You are so slow. Werewolf against this dude. What is this dude? Burn. Okay, like... It's 2v1 situation now, my dude. It's a 2v1 situation now. Let me tell you that much. Oh my goodness, man. So, you know, there is little to nothing we can do right now. Besides reviving Karsh, reviving the heroes is so expensive too, you know. Normally, you always pay a percentage of the recruiting price. Like when you recruit, for example, Gandalf for 6k and then you need to revive him, you don't need to pay 6k again. It's a big punishment, in my opinion. We have all the heroes from this. This hero is still dead, but we don't need him. He's quite weak. Okay, this is gonna be taken down eventually. Great, great, great. What is this guy able to do? Guardsman, Enforcer. Can fight as a Guardsman or as an Enforcer. As Guardman, his attacks reduce the damage of enemy heroes by 35% for 5 seconds. As an Enforcer, they reduce the armor of enemy heroes instead, okay? Pretty nice, pretty nice. So let's keep moving on. Now let's limit test with the army with 14 power points collected. Holy guacamole. So we have a couple of options now, boys. We can also go for the big boy, the stronghold of the Iron Crown. Nominees selected fortress as a stronghold of the Iron Crown. Okay. Then we have also the outbreak. Create a terrible plague at the enemy, which damages enemy units inside it and will be spread automatically. Blackguard officers. Thralls gain 3 times as much health and can now summon the stronger orcs from Mount Graham. And vassals can gain improved hit points and deal more damage. Summon 3 battalions, okay. And summon heal trolls. So let's get the big boy. And I'm actually curious if we can also update this one. No? No, that's not possible. I think it's only possible on this one. So what is happening now? What is this now? Oh, okay. That's what it is. All right. Sortie. Allied units within fortress gained 50% damage. And we've also unleashed the Black Knights. Victory! Nothing can stop us, sire. For 30 seconds, all walls and buildings are surrounded by snowstorm, making them invulnerable. In Stronghold of the Witch King, the fortress has been upgraded to a Stronghold of the Iron Crown. All structures have been upgraded to rank 3 and their garrisons have been reinforced with wall catapults have now ice munitions. Enemies near gate are poisoned. The citadel has the ability to... Okay, so... It's like a passive thing, but it's like a big investment of 10 power points for that, you know? It's kind of weak a little bit, not gonna lie. Let's get this one for more cooldown on the abilities, just why not? Now it's kind of worth it because we have a lot of levels. Here they come. Let's also get some... Oh, we have enough money now for the Witch King boy, so let's go for the big boy. Karsh has returned. It also took him ages to get returned on the menu, boys. So let's keep moving on from this side. He's trying to take down our structures. Alright, so this is gonna be taken down for sure. There is no way we can defend this, guys. But it's fine. Karsh can maybe make something happen? Question mark? Oh, he won't be there in time either. He won't be there in time either. What are these units? Oh yeah, these are the Shadow Knights. Alright, Shadow Knights, you go there. These are the special units you are only able to recruit once you use the stronghold of the Iron Crown. I believe. Okay, let's take down the level 3 mineshaft, that's good. Take this, nice. Destroy this right after. Karsh is level 2 now, that's good. Looks like we will be able to save this. Hopefully. They have no long shot though. They are just ignoring Karsh completely. And there comes the Witch King, ladies and gentlemen. On foot. But you can also get mounted on the Black Horse. And you're gonna look like this. He's looking like a badass. Look at him, guys. Look at this design of the Witch King, ladies and gentlemen. In the Edain mod for BFME to the Rise of the Witch King. Harbinger of Winter. Despite not revealing himself as one of the Nazgul, the menacing aura of the Witch King fills those around him with terror. All enemies nearby will passively lose 20% armor. The effect of this ability is small storm, which doubles the reduction for a short time. So let's get this mounted with the dude. And then we can fight this, no problemo. Also, this has been taken down. It's very unfortunate. You guys are moving here to support the army with additional damage. Okay, wait a second. Someone is texting me all the time in Discord, which is really... Hold on, please. Okay, I fixed this guy, sorry. Iron Hills. Okay, beautiful. So, I mean, these cards are kind of useless now, right? Yeah, I think so. I want to see how this is looking like. Oh, looks nice. Looks nice. And now we just need to find the One Ring, but I believe that's also easier said than done. Because I have not heard about Gollum yet. And it's also kind of a tricky map, so let's get this outpost maybe. Alright, so let's group all together. Witch King is also here now, that's good. Just stay here right there. We're in a good spot, we have almost full map control. Let's get this outpost. And let's use our knights to search for the One Ring. Oh no, that's not Gollum. I was able to see something on the map, but I thought I was wrong. I was clearly wrong. That's not Gollum, guys. But I like this map. This map is looking kind of good. I wish there would be an ability which could kind of, you know, like reveal the map. And this way, it's gonna become easier to find the Gollum. Oh, they have like a cooldown. Okay. We need a Siege Works maybe here. I mean, we can also get Siege Works from this. But it's kind of a bit far away, you know? Yes, Siege Weapons. That's why it's so hard. Let's build the Siege Works. That's gonna be... Siege equipment, yeah, there we go. Now, this has some upgrades, I believe. I believe it's gonna make it... Oh, we have also now this hero. Okay. So, it's a brand new hero from this. And I believe we can get even a different hero from this. Garrison Tower. Alright. So, let's make mill.
We will retake our homeland.
I mean, where is the Gollum? Bring me the Gollum. Bring me the Gollum. Okay, we can get one more of these on the field. It would be nice.
Forming up into a force to be feared.
This has been taken down. Yeah, level 2. Oh, guys, my game just got an error. Out of memory. Oof. This technical difficulty is all the time, dude. I couldn't finish the Dwarven faction. What is going on? Why? Look, direct 3x error. Also, out of memory. Because of the severity of this error, the game will now exit. Holy guacamole, guys. Rest in peace. Rest in peace. Yeah, anyways, guys, I believe I'm gonna upload this anyway. Hopefully, you was able to get like a sneak peek about the Angmar faction. Angmar seems really solid, strong. Unfortunately, we were not able to find the ring on this map. That's why I like to play on map Force of Eisen, which you guys don't like to see, which I can understand. Because, you know, Gollum can be everywhere and he's invisible most of the time unless you are getting really close to him. But anyways, guys, it was fun to play with Angmar. GG well played. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please don't forget to leave a like on this video. And also check me out on my second YouTube channel for the Twitch highlight videos if you are not able to catch me live on the Twitch TV. And, you know, I see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.